Joyce Awards was started in 2004 and is one of the only regional programs supporting new artistic commissions by pioneering artists of color working in collaboration with communities in six Great Lakes cities. Congratulations to this year's 2023 Joyce Awards winners. We can't wait to see your ideas come to life.
I believe the artwork invites us to tell nuanced stories about our lives, and I'm so excited to be the recipient of a Joyce Award. As an artist, I draw on my experience as the daughter of Chinese and Ecuadorian immigrants to co-design works with low-wage workers, immigrant families, and public housing residents. The Joyce Award has enabled me to create Hoops, which is an outdoor recreational play space outside the National Public Housing Museum in Chicago.
The National Public Housing Museum is the only cultural institution dedicated to preserving, promoting, and propelling the right of all people to a place where they can live and prosper, a place to call home. Hoops celebrates and uplifts the living history of recreation and play spaces in and around public housing and mixed income communities.
In Hoops, the geometries and line work of basketball, foursquare, hopscotch, and other street games begin to merge, and they begin to take a life of their own, extending the play space. As someone who has lived in and worked within different kinds of public housing, I want my artwork to inspire and shift how we design for equity.
I create artwork that teaches people about Dakota culture, relationships, and history. Together with the Franconia Sculpture Park, I will be creating my augmented reality project called Spawning Indigenous Reverence. Visitors will be able to surround themselves within stories from the Dakota community about our relationship to Grandmother Earth, experiencing the world through our eyes using augmented reality.
Native artists have been creating land art on this continent for millennia, and we believe that Marlena's project is a necessary extension of this. She is creating land art in a completely digital sense without having to disturb the land at all. Why spend thousands of dollars creating an installation and disturbing the land when your work can exist in any place or time?
Winning the Joyce Award means I'll have the support to include more Dakota voices from our communities in my installations. It's important to me that our storytellings, our teachings, and our contemporary art hold the same space. The use of augmented reality can help overcome the challenges of having our land taken from us, helping restore our stories, languages, and art to sacred sites. The Joyce Award will help advance augmented reality in the art world as both sculpture and a way to claim our relationship to land back, empowering Native storytelling into the future by spawning Indigenous reverence today.
Allahu, 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 Allahu.
Our project is singing together Qawwali and gospel. And while Qawwali stems from Islam, I use it as a way to build relationships with other BIPOC communities.
Mandala is known for its programs that represent the diverse linguistic, cultural, and gender identities that arise from South Asia and the South Asian diaspora. Through Sonny's rendition of Qawwali and his use of multiplicity, I'm confident that many communities in Chicago will find parallels with each other, be in the same room together, to listen to the same music together, and understand each other.
This project is focused on Black Americans and South Asian Americans and how we can find common ground, how we can address the issues of prejudice and racism that exists within, and then how can we build a better tomorrow together.
As a Filipino Salvadorian interdisciplinary artist, I make intimate and large-scale and durational works that center the efforts of queer, gender nonconforming, and their advocates. It is incredibly moving to become part of the Joyce Awards network. I'm honored to receive the invitation that weaves my practice into partnership with the work of Cleveland's artist-centered organization, Spaces. And it offers a chance to work with the relationship that Spaces has with the longest running LGBTQ center in the country, in the Rust Belt, based in Cleveland's diverse community.
Spaces is located in the heart of Cleveland, Ohio, and we have been working as the resource and public forum for artists to explore and experiment. We're really excited to be working with Julie to build together advocacy, resistance, and engagement.
The project is a centering space for us to think about how to carry on in a constantly pressurized and shifting world, and how we can create environments that are formed by refusal and connection.
I use photography and other media to explore the relationships between memory, history, language, and Black landscapes. These projects are partially inspired by my family history, including migration stories and my own individual experiences. I'm originally from Houston, Texas, but I grew up moving around with my family through countries such as Nigeria, Congo, Cameroon, South Africa, and parts of Europe. For my project, Shorelines, in partnership with the Museum of Contemporary Photography, I will develop a new, large-scale, site-specific photographic installation. This installation will explore the unique histories and geographies of Black lakefront communities in Chicago and across the Great Lakes.
Working with Regina on Shorelines is a total dream project. She's showing the way to really develop a holistic city where everyone is honored.
Community engagement is a key part of my research-based practice. And for this project, I'm looking forward to exploring archival photographs and community archives, recording oral histories, and many other ways of engaging directly with the community that I'm in conversation with. I'm very excited to have this opportunity.